Our power, the unchallengeable power, the stubborn power. I've got to pursue the onslaught of the enemy. For there's a word of God not only on your body, soul, and spirit, but every organ in your body. This afternoon, God really break me. He really show me some areas that I need to release myself. I need to do something different. I need to come up higher. How many of you know that every time God is gonna bring you to another place in Him, He's gonna break you, He's gonna prune you. And it's important that He does that, because if He doesn't do that, the old lava, the old things, it will kind of encroach upon the new thing that God wants to do. So give God the glory that we are people that God prune. He break us sometimes, because He don't want us to be humiliated by the enemy. So I was praying with one of my spiritual daughter yesterday, and she said something remarkable to me. A while in prayer, she said, "You know what? I come to carry myself." It just changed the scope of my ministerial understanding about the courts of heaven and accusation. And I said, instead of Satan carrying us to the Lord, where we know we're guilty of offense, where we know we're guilty of using others, making people feel bad, where we know we're guilty and we can't find the spiritual decorum to go and say, "God, I hand myself in. I know I have some ways about me." It is profane. It's not your righteous standard for me. When you can reach that level in God, when you can say, "God, you know what, I turn myself in, trust me, I am telling you," you can know the heart of that individual. You know, when you have murderers and killers that are on the loot and police are looking for them, and you will find out that a murderer has turned himself in. You will find out that a child molester, a pedophile has turned themselves in. How much more us, when we are wrong, when we are unrighteous, when we do things that are not good. How about us just taking ourselves and turn ourselves into the Lord? You will never reach that destiny, hallelujah, destination, if there are so much things on you that is not written in your book. You and I, child of God, we're on a quest to get the things that are not written about us by God, off us, away from us. It must be nullified. It must be execrated. It must not be a part of us, so that when the glory of God is ready to be revealed, everyone will say, "Oh my God, she doesn't only say it, she lives it. He doesn't only preach it, he lives it." Can I have a witness on this line in the prophetic name of Jesus tonight? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Those who are unproductive, God has no place for them in His kingdom. For if you're unwilling to be pruned, if you're unwilling to humble yourself, you will be classified as a reject. There was a biblical character by the name of Saul. When Samuel the prophet gave Saul instruction and direction, Saul go and do his own thing. How many of you know that when you're having your you're telling God, "Well, your instruction is not good enough for me," and in no distant time, God is going to move that prophet. Hallelujah. God is going to move that pastor. God wants people who are transfigurating as the Spirit is transfigurating. The Spirit of God is very transfigurative. He will never leave you the same way He finds you. Can I have a witness on this global platform? Hallelujah. If you are still in the old you, you are not transfigurated. If you're still in the past, you have not even embrace your future. And so for that, we run to the Father, who is the ransomer of our soul, and we give Him thanks and we give Him praise. Welcome, saints, again. This is a great night. Great things are about to happen tonight. Can we pray right now in the prophetic name of Yahushua? Father, I want to welcome you tonight to this global platform. Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. We thank you for your marvelous work. Tonight we're in the courts, Lord God. We want to come to the court of the General Assembly of the saints of the firstborn, the church that is registered in heaven, mighty God. We ask, oh God, that the courts will be open according to Hebrews chapter 12, 1 and 2. We ask that every ministry presented here that is registered by you in the courts of heaven, that our ministry will be presented. Creator of the universe, we begin to ask that all these courts that I'm calling will be open tonight. The court of wisdom, the court of understanding, the court of excellence, the court of deliverance by fire. We ask, oh God, that you will send Angel Raguel to upload the marvelous wisdom of God. Angels with flaming fire tonight, Talabakusaya, to escort the ministry to another dimension where evil cannot pluck it up, evil cannot root it, where we will produce the fruit of the Spirit. For we ask tonight that you will activate the knowledge of God, that you will remove from us the polluting knowledge that keep us in bondage. Father, we ask tonight that there will be a deliverance from the leadership and the worship team of heaven. We ask for the manifestation of the Spirit of God. Let there be revival tonight. Let there be healing. The children need bread tonight. God, we ask that you will forgive us of our ways, and our actions and our words and our attitude. We ask that you will strip rebellion. You will pull down the stronghold. You will pull down a pride and self-righteousness. We ask tonight in the name of Yahshua that you will strip us of self-righteous breastplate and arrogance tonight, that we will walk in the unction of the Holy Ghost to a high degree tonight in the name of Yahshua. Any belt of deception, any pollution that is in us and on us, producing seeds of the Nephilim, strangulating the prophetic seed of God, we embrace your righteousness tonight and ask to be partaker of the commonwealth of Israel. We bind the strong man of religiosity. We loose and confess that we ain't religious, we are righteous. We ask that you will remove judgment and hypocrisy. We ask that you will remove pollution, anything that derive from the flesh, anything that is revived from an ungenerated mind. Hale bosakuriabados kotoria. We ask that these earthen vessels tonight that is presented here, that you will store up the hidden treasures in us. Oh God, your word declared that in us lies hidden treasure. We ask that you will store up the treasures tonight, the gifts tonight, the oil tonight. We ask that you will beautify us with salvation, God. Mandolo boko se telebe kuria. Oh, great God of the universe, let your fire go forth tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, and all God's children shout aloud, amen. In Jesus' prophetic name, hallelujah.
Amen, hallelujah.
Amen, amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Everlasting. Amen. And his truth, amen, and glory for all generations. I want to give God thanks for the opportunity that I have to encounter him in a positive way. And I want God to empty me tonight and empty you tonight so we can move into the new phase of destiny. Tonight, we're under a divine team. The team is strategic. It is taken from the scripture of in Isaiah 55 verse 11. For the Bible says that, so my word that goes out from my mouth, it shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish accomplish that which it purpose, and it shall succeed in the things that I sent it for to do. So with that said, tonight we want to ask God to breathe upon us, because there are some of us that we have a lot of prophetic words that have been spoken over our lives, and sometimes it seems as if that word or those words are not coming into fruition, are not being manifested. But I'm here to challenge your mind and to activate your most Holy Spirit, that if the Lord has spoken a word over you, come hell, come Hades, come hallelujah fire, the Lord will cause the heavens to be activated, and all the words that he has spoken over your life, if you do not walk contrary to him, those words will come into fruition. Those words will come into actualization. Those words will bring manifestation in the mighty name of Jesus. The reason why many of us don't experience these words quickly come into fruition, for immediately when a prophetic word is given, the prophetic word have to find a landing strip in your life. And oftentimes you don't just stand on the word alone. You couple it with intercession. You couple it with the way of living. You couple it so when the angel come, he will not find you insubordinate. He will not find you out of the perimeter of the actualization of the word. And so it is imperative that people know that when a word is given, we are challenged. When a word is given, we are propelled. When a word is given, we are provoked. When a word is given, sometimes it accelerates our joy. We are emotionally, hallelujah, triggered to laugh, like Sarah, or like, hallelujah, like Abraham, when they were told that a pregnancy is coming from a woman who have passed the year of conception. Some of God's words, they are provocative. Some of God's words, they look impossible. And so tonight, God is speaking to us. There are so many things around us that wants to prohibit the manifestation of God's word. I don't know what you have learned about God, but what I've learned about God is, if God has given you a word, if you walk contrary with God, then God will walk contrary with you. In Hebrews 4 and verse 12, the word of God says, "For the word of God is living and it's active, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing and dividing of soul and spirit and of joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and the intent of the heart." Can somebody help me bless God that there is a cutting edge, hallelujah, prophetic destiny that you and I have been called to. That destiny began a long time ago. Before time began, the word was spoken over your life. Before you have the understanding to read the Bible, before you know biblical interpretation, or anyone as a taught you regarding the word, there was something that was spoken over you. And so there is a prophet of God in the Bible. You can turn your Bible with me to the book of Jeremiah, hallelujah, chapter 1. There is this awesome prophetic vessel that God, hallelujah, had spoken so profound. This word is so profound that was spoken in Jeremiah. And the word of God says from Jeremiah 1, I'm going to read from verse 3 going down. And it says, "Then the word of the Lord came unto me as saying," when God called you, there's always going to be a word of the Lord. It cannot be an imaginary thing. It cannot be, "I feel like." there must be a word of the Lord concerning you. So the word of the Lord came to the prophet Jeremiah and say unto him, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee. I ordained thee as a prophet unto the nation. There is a word that is on us. There's a word that has gone forth over us. Some people take the word with gratitude. Some people wrestle with the word. Some people try to figure out the word. Jeremiah was one of them that wrestled with the word, that tried to figure out the word. In verse 6 of Jeremiah chapter 1, the Bible says, then said I, our Lord, behold, I cannot speak, for I am but a child. And the Lord said, be not of, the Lord says, but the Lord said unto me, say not that I'm a child. Thou shalt go to all that I shall send thee, and whatsoever I command thee, thou shalt speak. Praise the name of the Lord. So there must be a word of the Lord over your life. There must be a word of the Lord over your destiny. Praise the name of the Lord. And so even though we are in a world where systems are organized by Satan. Satan as an organized host of hell with major division, and these division are called principality. This division, they are called principality, and he has placed some of the most powerful demons at the head of each principalities, and each of these demons has responsibility to spread particular band of setbacks, frustration, doubt and fear, temptation and bondages, sicknesses and untimely death. Once you understand that God's word outrank a principality and a power, it outrank what man says, it outrank what man do. For the word of God is no ordinary thing. For the word of God is God in spirit, God in a word form. Can somebody say the word of God is serious over my life, and I can't play with it, in the prophetic name of Jesus? Hallelujah. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. So we have to understand that though there are problems in this age, this problem was not now. This problem has been, hallelujah, orchestrated from the pit of hell and the belly of hell years ago before you and I came into existence. But it's the spoken word of God that has activated the realm of protection, has activated the word in our lives. So that's why we are not dead, even though we are under onslaught. And so when you understand the biblical teaching regarding Satan's supernatural power and God's omnipotent power and the warfare that occasionally daily happen in the earth and in the heaven, if you can comprehend the biblical teaching on this point and how to retaliate, recognizing that truth outstand lies, and hallelujah, God will turn up the truth in the situation. If you have God in your child of God, it don't matter how they try to malign you, it don't matter how they try to shut your mouth. If you have a word in you, if it is a true word, you can confront that devil, you can confront that situation by standing on the truth, where you square your shoulder and say, eyeball to eyeball, the word of God is authoritative. The word of God is circled on heaven and in earth. The word of God is a force to be reckoned with. It shall not return to him void. And what God say about me is what I believe, witches and wizards. You could pray your psychic prayer. You can call your prayer warrior only the word of God, the counsel of God over my life shall come into fruition. Where were you when God called me? Where were you when he paid the price for me? You cannot sabotage my destiny, for you are not worthy to be praised. Can somebody unmute their phone and scream from the top of your lungs, there is a word of the Lord over my life in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
There is a word of the Lord over my life.
There is a word of God over my life.
There is a word of God over my life in the name of Jesus.
There is a word over my life in the name of Jesus.
Satan has supernatural power. Huh? Make no mistake about that fact. So, and if you're in a church that they don't want to teach you about the Satan, Paul says you are not to be ignorant of the enemy's devices. That means he is coming with tricks, he's coming with demons, he's coming with axes and vexes and spells, he's coming with unnatural, supernatural forces. But God says in Luke 10:19, I have given you power over all the power. So that means God cannot make a mistake. God cannot lie. He knows the power of the enemy long before you came into fruition or existence. And he said, even though the enemy come in on you like a flood, I have still given you power. Your power is still supreme power. You have all power in you. Don't let the devil dictate to you. Don't let the devil apprehend you. Don't let the devil suspend you. Handilio shata. What you lack is, hallelujah, the ability to step in the raw power that make things work. What you are denying yourself of is acknowledging God in power. For there is no power like his power. The Bible says all a power belong to God. Come on, somebody, if you're on this line and you're in a bind, you will never, hallelujah, feel God's power at work until you unleash it. You gotta unleash the power. You gotta speak the power into existence. All the prophets and pastors and bishops and everyone in the Bible that were used by God, they spoke the power into existence. They did not just memorize it. They actualize it. They invoked it. They superimpose it. They release it. They adjust atmosphere. They adjust hemisphere. They take regions because of the spoken word of God. Am I on the right platform tonight? There is a power that needs to be confronted. There is a truth that needs to be recognized. There are situations that need to conform. And what God is waiting for is for you to utter that word out of your mouth. Jeremiah says, I'm but a child. I cannot utter that word. I'm but a child. I don't have the intellectual ability. I need to acquire more. There is an acquisition that I need for application of the revelation that you're giving me, God. And Jeremiah says, I cannot go. Moses says, I'm not eloquent enough. But what you need to know, that the vital force of the Spirit of God in you, the breath of God in you, is the breath of the Almighty. Job 32:8, it is the breath of the Almighty. When God sent a word over you, is backing it with sign. This is not just mere flesh. This is not just the word that you hear, like what you hear from artificial intelligence. When you call Siri, this word is life-giving. This word of capacity to create. This word of capacity capacity to heal, to deliver, to raise from the dead. This word is multidimensional, transdimensional. This word that God has brought over our life, if we accurately stay in it and allow it to process us, hallelujah, all the spiritual data, all the things that is embedded in the word, that is inhabiting in the word, that is life enhancing, destiny altering, mandalala boshata, promotion given. It's the word that is going to increase us. It's the word that is associated with the realm that you came from. It is the word that bring you into relationship with God. It's the word that enhances your spiritual equilibrium and your spiritual, intelligence. So God have a word for us. Hallelujah. There is a distinction between the academical intelligence versus the supernatural spiritual intelligence that come from God. Hallelujah. This is not as a result of your IQ or your CQ. Mandelebo Shadabaha. God wants us to pull on his word, for word, the word of God is able to change a nation. The word of God is full of so much, hallelujah, miraculous insight into things that we need to know. Some of you are chasing down just your academical intelligence. Hallelujah. Don't know that every sphere of us have an intelligent realm that operated. That's how great God's word is. That's how great God is. Some of us, our emotional life, we know that we have to operate in emotional intelligence, cultural intelligence, linguistic, logical, hallelujah, mathematical intelligence, and all the intelligence, hallelujah, that we need is in God. And God says, you're wondering what to do, and I've spoken a word over your life. My word is multidimensional. It is incorporated not just at one level. Can somebody say, I'm getting a better awareness? Hallelujah.
I am getting a better awareness. Hallelujah.
Child of God, when you walk into a region with the word, that's why Satan has to use tricks and trade to get us out of the realm of the word. He throw an arrow of depression, you get out of the word. He throw an arrow of, hallelujah, poverty, you get out of the word. I command the word to take root in us. I command the word to medicate us. I command the word to sustain us, to catapult us, to work in us for our good, to take us to the next level. We are in a deceptive era. Mantakusata. And it's the word of God. What did God say about you? What did God say about you? Your destiny. Praise the name of the Lord. You are not the only one that Satan challenges the word. Hallelujah. You are not the only one that Satan challenges the word on your life and in your, hallelujah, over your destiny. There was a man in the book of Job. Hallelujah. The Bible tells us in Job 1:6-7. He said, now there was a day when the Son of God came to present themselves before the Lord. And Satan came along among them. And the Lord said to Satan, whence comest thou? Then Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and fro in the earth and from walking up and down in it. Then God asked Satan, have you considered my servant a Job? Hallelujah. One that feared God and ensured evil. And Satan said, most likely, and I'm paraphrasing, Satan love you for naught. Isn't it because you put an edge around him? Take away the edge. and let's see if Job really loved you. My God in Zion, like Job, some of us, because of the word of God in us and over our lives, God is bragging about us. Have you considered my daughter, Apostle Anike Israel, that she loves me and she will do anything for me? And Satan will say, does she love you for not? Not just me, but any one of us who God has given a word. Satan will make sure you miss sight of the word. You don't trust the word anymore. Praise God, by constant bombardment, by constant attack. Child of God, if Job did not have the word in his belly, the word over his life, when he heard the first bad news, he will be running mad. When he hear the first bad news, he will be questioning God's ability and God's sovereignty to keep him even in the heights of testing. Job understood that if I cannot do anything else for myself at this point, if I can believe the word, though maggot is eating my flesh, though after my flesh the worm destroyed, yet in my eyes, the mind of my eyes, I can see God. Can somebody say there's a word over my life and God is in control of me? Shout hallelujah in the name of Jesus tonight. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Child of God, when God allow you to be tested, it's not just you that has been tested, Pastor Ingrid Ron Paul. It's the word in your belly. Do you really have the word? Hallelujah. Bakoboshata Mandilio Shato Roboko City. Do you really have the word? Or do you have fear? Do you really have the word, or you're a gossiper? Do you really have the word in you, Kusata? What do you have? The test will prove. What do you have in you? Makabo Shataribi Kusata. The word in the Greek is the name Logos. It means a word. It's a terminology that is used for word. And so when God speak a word over your life, do you expect to have a smooth sailing? Or God says, I'm going to be a governmental prophet. I'm going to be a CEO of a 10 companies. I'm going to be married. I'm going to have this. Do you think that Satan is going to allow you to go through all those blessings? No attack, no resistance, smooth sailing. You gotta think again. So in Ephesians 2 verse 6, the Apostle Paul calls Satan the prince of the power of the air. It refers to air. Air refers to the surrounding elements of the earth. It is just another way of saying the earth. Paul, Apostle Paul, picture here is that Satan is being absolutely a dictator. He's a prince. He's a dictator. The Apostle John also speaks as Satan in John 12:31 and John 14:30. Hallelujah. He spoke about Satan. Satan is called many names. He's called the accuser of the brethren. He is called the old serpent. He's called the dragon. He's called Lucifer. Praise the name of Jesus. He's called the prince of the air. He's an absolute dictator. So when God says you are blessed, he will dictate the word and say you are cursed. In Daniel, hallelujah, in the book of Daniel chapter 3, we see godly forces and satanic forces battling control of kings and kingdom. In chapter 10, we see where Satan and his demonic hosts are actively, hallelujah, trying to withstand the word, the prayer for the answer of prophet Daniel as he seeks the Lord. We see that among us today, Satan has raised up against the word of God in the church, in our homes, among the political arena, among leaders. Hallelujah. We're seeing that the word of God God, over churches, over nation, over municipality, over different constituencies are being challenged by demonic hierarchy. But God says, nevertheless, it's my word that is going to superimpose on the jurisdiction of the enemy and flip the devil off his throne. Satan cannot take another territory because you and I refuse the spoken word. I am here to emphatically decree and declare that it's time for the word to be manifest. It's time for the word of God to be manifested in our life on every scale and every aspect, every sphere of our life. Can somebody say, I know the word is already manifesting, but there are greater dimensions of the word that needs to manifest in me. Am I talking to the church of God? In the mighty name of Jesus, when God called you, what did he speak over you? Why are you afraid? Why are you afraid? You are the only one, hallelujah, that can allow the enemy to stop what God does or the next move of God. Satan cannot block it and stop it unless you allow it. Can you type it? Satan cannot block it or stop it. What is it? The word. He cannot block the word. He cannot stop the word over my life. Heaven and earth is going to pass away, and God cannot afford the heaven that was created and given as a covenant to humanity. God did not cause the world to pass away in Noahic dispensation. He will not cause the world to pass away in my dispensation. Rather, his word will come to pass over us. Shout hallelujah to the Lamb of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And so, hallelujah, there is so many theoretically, hallelujah, uninformed. They are theoretically uninformed. We know that God is the key to humanity. In him lies all the solution to earth perplexing a problem. Praise the name of the Lord. In going into deep theology tonight, there are seven demons you must overcome to make the word of God, hallelujah, come to pass with ease. We are going into it tonight. Can somebody say, go deep with me tonight? Satan apparently think that he controls the earth. He think that he's the government of the earth. Revelation 2:13, tell me that it is not so. Another Bible verse says that the heaven is God's throne, but the earth is his footstool. That means that God is even greater than Satan. Just by his footstool being in the earth, we are protected. For Psalms 110 say, I will sit at the right hand of God until my enemies become my footstool. Can somebody praise God on this platform? So in Revelation 2, verse 13, we see that Jesus said something, and it's very interesting what he said, for it was a word of commendation to the churches of Pergamon and Pergamos. The cities were extremely wealthy, trading city in Asia, a minor and deeply immersed in the pagan worship. But Jesus said, I have something about you. And he was sending the angel to write to the churches. These things he says, which the sharp sword with the two edges, Jesus says, I know thy work, where thou dwellest, even where Satan's seat is, and all you hold fast to my name, and has not denied my faith. Even in those days when Antipas, my faithful martyr, was slain. Hallelujah, among you, because he dwell where Satan dwell. Child of God, even though the revelation was given to Apostle Paul that Antipas died a faithful martyr, even when you dwell in the stronghold of Satan, even when you live where the seat of Satan is, if there's a word of God on your life, if there's a word of God in you, Satan will lose all his place of dominion. If you work with God, God will work with you until you dispossess him. That is your kingdom assignment. That is your kingdom assignment. Any property of yours in the hands of the devil, God is going to endow you so much with so much power and revelation that you will be used by God to demote the devil out of everywhere he exists. You will be used by God to superimpose his defeat and to run him out of the territory. A shout hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. It is clear that many of us still don't know who we are. We don't know the power. I bet if I was casting out demon, everybody will be shouting. But tonight I'm learning to invoke the power of God. Tonight there are some things that just need God's power to show up. It don't need long prayer. It don't need long prophetic decrees. It need God raw power. Is omnipotent power. Is infinite power. It need the power. Hallelujah. So Satan is doing so much things. Hallelujah. But God, praise the Lord. But God is saying his power is still available. God's power is omnipotent power. God's power is infinite power. God's power is the power that nothing can withstand. Hallelujah. For with God all things are possible. Luke 1:37. God is a power. It is far greater than the power of demons and devils and fallen angels and witches and wizards. God's power cannot be comprehended. God's power cannot be limited. You are all over the world watching me. Makabo Shataba. And right where you are by the power of God, God can touch your life, touch your situation, pull down the stronghold, heal your body, regulate your heart, and heal your mind in the mighty name of Jesus. Is there a word of God over you? One word of God over you is greater than 10 million word of the devil on you. For God is greater. He's great in power. He's great in all ramification. Ephesians 3:20 says our God, hallelujah, it talks about the God who is omnipotent. God power is shown in creation. It's shown in the universe. It's shown in us being maintained. It shows us that God is greater. His power is greater. Ain't no devil in hell can act you and stop you and block you, derail you, even kill you. Once the Godhead is for you, come on somebody, there is a power that is great in the universe. It is superpower. It is unstoppable. So when God put a word over your life, when you grasp that word, God expect you to start to speak the word over your life so that the word will be as a superimposition over the enemy. God reveal himself through his word. He sustained the universe by the spoken word of God. We heard that the old creation came into existence. I don't know who God sent me here for tonight, but I feel in my belly that Satan wanna divert some of us. But the word of God God on our life says, hallelujah, you shall be blessed, you shall be healed, you shall be successful, you shall run to those troops and leap over those walls. It is me that gird you with strength for the battle, for I will make your feet like hinds' feet. And though you're surrounded by haters, your enemy shall come against you one way and shall flee seven ways. You must get the word of God in you, particularly in this end time. If you don't have the word of God in your, if you don't have it in you and you stand on it, God, you said I'm healed, God, you said I'm blessed, God, you said I shall not die, even if you don't remember, hallelujah, the exact Koroboshatabaha, the exact Bible verse that is taken from Makabushatabaha. As long as you've got that word in your belly, child of God, and you know that God has spoken, when the enemy come up against you, you must remind God of his word. Don't remind him of how much people are attacking you. Remind him of his word. God, you say, I wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principality and power, against rulers of darkness and wicked spirit in high places, according to Ephesians 6:12. God, I am releasing myself that you will kill this principality assigned against me. You will kill this power that is trying to dethrone me. You will destroy the wickedness in high places that is entrenched against me. You need to bring the word of God, because when there's a word of God over your life, Satan better watch it, for the word of God is spirit. The word of God is God. You need to rise up in faith and say, God, didn't you say in Isaiah 54 verse 17 that no weapon that is form against me shall prosper? Every word that rises against me, I will condemn it. I will condemn it. I will condemn it. Can you open your phone line and help me say any word over my life? Whether it's voodoo, whether it's God, this is what the sovereign God is saying. In order for my word to come to pass in your life, hallelujah, you got to deal with the situations that exist to prohibit the manifestation. I want to bless you because the Lord is faithful. He will establish you and keep you from evil. The Lord will surely gather you together, hallelujah, and make you release you in a safe place. He said, don't worry about them, Anarchy. Don't worry about them, child of God. For behold, they shall surely gather together, but not by me. When God said, whosoever, whether it's principality or power, whosoever shall gather together against thee, they shall fall for your sake. That's how important we are to God. That any man that touch you, they touch the apple of his eye. And God don't treat those who provoke the apple of his eye lightly. Come on, somebody. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. And so in order for you to get this dimension of power, you got to deal with some principality. That is why Jesus Christ, before he went to the cross, he dealt with the principalities. All night he prayed until his sweat become like drops of blood. He was praying. He was maintaining a soundness of mind, maintaining a godly momentum. He was there penetrating all his realm with his godship. He wanted to make sure his supremacy was ruling his humanity. And he spent all night of praying for divine intervention from his father Kushatabakusete. He did not use it, the power of God. Hallelujah, carelessly. He pray. He work up a sweat. Makabo shata with groaning and supplication to provide salvation for sin, to establish the church, to have us move. Hallelujah. In a mighty dimension of power. He gained that authority and jurisdiction through the crucifixion. Hallelujah, Jesus, somebody. I feel the power is coming. Tonight, I want you to know, because God cannot lie, that prophecy over your life must be activated. It must dominate you. It must overthrow the devil on a cliff. It must kill the naysayers and the skeptics. It must kill the opinionation of you. Baba Shoto, there was no substitute for the sacrifice of sin. The omnipotent God by his omnipotent power, hallelujah, came down and robed himself in flesh and say, I will voluntarily give up my life so that all that come to me will live, devil. So you have nothing on them. If they have a word on them, if they have the word in them, I am the supreme sacrifice, the acceptable sacrifice. I satisfy the judicial, hallelujah, the judicial requirement for righteousness for humanity. I shut down hell and eternal debt, and I call forth a people unto myself. Am I on the right platform tonight? So we have nothing to fear. Come hell, come
man.
What a kilobo shandaba. Whatever the word of
hallelujah.
God,
glory to God.
Life, I command you to believe it. I command you to receive it. Let God synchronize, syncopate you with his word. Shout hallelujah to the Lamb of God.
Hallelujah.
Daddy, you say, I shall not die. Psalms 118, verse 16 to 17. This is your word. God, you told me before your word don't come to fruition, you're going to take away heaven. Let me see you take away heaven now. Take away the heaven, God. Take away the earth, because that's what you say. If your word don't come true over my life, heaven must disappear. Come on, somebody. Earth must disappear. And because we know that the earth and the heaven is not going anywhere, then the word of God must come to pass. Shout hallelujah in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. surround you. You need the word to be bulldozed it. For in Zechariah 4 verse 6, then he answered unto me saying this word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel. It was a word of the Lord. It was not a word of man. It was a word of the Lord. Can somebody shout the word of the Lord? For any power that wants to kill me before my time, loose me by the word of God. I release the word of God as a dagger against you. Every power assigned to kill me, I lose the word as a dagger. Every satanic power assigned to kill me, you're a liar.
You're a liar. I receive the word. I release the word of God as a dagger in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Jesus, hallelujah. I release the word of God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
The word of God pierce you in the name of Jesus. I lose the word. I lose the word of God to pierce you in the name of Jesus.
To kill you with heart attack. You heart attack. You are disease, you strong man, you are gun killer from my father's house, you are gun killer from unfriendly friend, you are gun killer. I draw forth the sword of God, I draw forth the dropping of God, and I pull you to death. Argon killer of my father's house. I am not your candidate. I have a word of God on my head. Can somebody say, I have a word? Stubborn pursuer.
I have a word.
To my heart. A sign to my brain. Stubborn pursuer.
Stubborn pursuer.
In my body. You are
in my body.
I release the word of God. I victimize you with the word.
I destroy you with the word of God in the name of Jesus.
When the enemy attack you and you know not where to do, where to go, and there's a word of God on you, witches and wizard have gathered to celebrate your downfall, but there's a word of God in you. Hallelujah. Satanic agent are already in your body. Hallelujah. They want to kill the organs of your body. A lady called me out of Philadelphia today, said my body is shutting down. I invite her on this platform because we're gonna kill the organ killer tonight. For there's a word
Jesus
of
Christ
God on our head. Jesus, shout hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
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 Argon killers must die. Argon killers must die. If that thing is attacking your heart, it is an argon killer or an argon assassin, because there's a word of God on your life. We cannot afford for you to die. We have to invoke the spear of the Lord. For the word of God says in Judges 5 verse 8, they chose new gods. Then was war in the gate. Was there not a shield or a spear seen among 40,000 in Israel? So any argon killer from your father's house, your mother's house, from the witchcraft coven, environmental coven, witches and wizards, any argon killer that they have sent against you tonight, God send me tonight to orchestrate destruction upon the enemy, to stop the enemy from stopping you, to pursue the enemy to a perpetual ending. Yoko Soto Rabaha, tonight we must find the power, the regal power, the raw power, the unchallengeable power, the stubborn power I've got to pursue the onslaught of the enemy, for there's a word of God not only on your body, soul, and spirit, but every organ in your body. They are numbered by God. The ear on your head, they are numbered by God. So woe unto the enemy that wants to kill the organs of your body. The word of God for your health, it must manifest. So what is the word of God? Hallelujah. 1 John 1:2-3. You shall prosper even as your soul prospereth and be in good health. Am I talking? So any enemy that wants to kill your organs, strike you with heart attack, strike you with brain disease, I am on a mission from God tonight. That organ killer is now we're going to bury him. Come on, somebody. I don't care if there are multiple organ killers.
Hallelujah.
In your body, there's a
every
word of
organ
God.
Killer must die by fire.
In the name of Jesus, I feel the Holy Ghost up in here.
Kosata.
Hallelujah. Gather them together. Let them call for the principality. Let them call for the legions. I hear the Holy Ghost says, tonight we're dealing with legions. Argon assassin, you can't deal with just one. For when you deal with the one in the head, the one in the toe tomorrow, you deal with the one in the toe tomorrow, the one in the back. We need multiple javelins of God, multiple sword of God. Argon killing legions from the pit of hell, the belly of hell, the mouth of hell, all spear of the Lord. Arise in your mighty power. Begin to kill legions of argon killers from a father's house, from a mother's house, from a location, from the job, in my bloodline. Come on, somebody. Where are you tonight?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God begin to say to me, some people are going to leave this line.
Hallelujah.
Wait tonight. Where's the lady from Philadelphia? Are you online? Andolobo Shata. Are you online, sister from Philadelphia? Are you there?
Amen.
You're there? Not you, sweetheart. There's a lady from Philadelphia that the enemy wants to kill all her organs. And she reached out to me today to let me know that her organs are dying. Robosha invited her. Sister Shana, are you online, please? Korosaturia Barustai. So when we want God to deliver us, we got to use his word. Sister Shana, I'm online asking for you. Where are you? Are you online, please? Sorry, people of God. Come online. We want to hear from you. She said her whole body is dying. She knows me over 5 years. And every time the enemy have her to the point of death, that's when God has sent her for deliverance. I get a word from the Lord.
I'm online, prophetess. I'm here.
God bless you, Sister Shana. And so God says, when there's a word of God on your life, you must not run down the enemy. You must not run away from the enemy. You must let the enemy run away from you. Use every weapon you can find. For the Bible admonishes us, men ought to pray all sorts of prayer and they are not to faint. Hallelujah. So God tell me tonight, because there's a word of God, hallelujah, on your life, you got to deal with the lesions that is called organ killers. And that's where we're going in this teaching tonight. It's a twofold teaching tonight. It's on the word, for the word is the power. But God says the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through Christ to the pulling down of strongholds. So along with the word, you need the weapon from God, divine arsenal. Come on, somebody. We're dealing with lesions that is attacking the body. Lesions is described as a unit of 3,000 to 6,000. Hallelujah. A legion is a regimental force of entities, a battalion of demons, a company of demons. The synonym or similar words for that is hordes, the host of hell, the multitude of hell. So God says to me, the reason why some of us not getting it, we're dealing with one demon when there's legions. One legion can be 3,000 to 6,000 demon attacking your heart, demon attacking your brain. Am I on the right line? We need to kick some legions, but tonight, in the name of Jesus, shout hallelujah to the Prince of Glory.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
There are seven demons. I need you to write down these names. Get your paper, write down these seven demons. We are going to repent of having them in our lives and our bloodline. So the high-ranking demon of hell don't have anything on us. Satan has seven high-ranking principality of hell, as taught to witches. Witches have been taught that these are the ruling principality over mosque and over different shrine. Hallelujah. They are high-ranking principality of hell. And I need you to get this. If you can get them off for you, these seven demons, you are unstoppable. Demon number one, Reggie, R-E-G-E. Reggie is a general of the occult. Hallelujah. He is the one that give, hallelujah, the youths them, provoke them to take marijuana. Is the god over drugs such as marijuana, cocaine, speed, LD, LSD, hallelujah, and all these kind of drugs. I want you to know that drugs is also sorcery, from where we get the word pharmakia. Where you get the word pharmacy. Pharmakia is drugs that is used in sorcery and witchcraft. Hallelujah. Reggie is the demon over this region. Hallelujah. Then you have another demon that is called Lars. L-A-R-Z. This demon promotes lust, homosexuality, bisexuality, adultery, and other pleasurable sexual defilation, such as a sexual perversion, pornography, and all these kind of illicit sexual thing. Then the next demon is Bacchus, B-A-C-C-H-U-S. Bacchus is the demon of addiction, smoking, alcoholism, all addiction stem from the demon that is called Bacchus. Then you have another demon that is called Pan. Pan is the demon of the mind. For people who have mental illnesses, depression, suicide, nervous breakdown, all these things is done through the demon that is called Pan. P-A-N. Then you have another demon that is called Merdit. M-E-R-D-I-T. This is the demon that promotes murder, killing, war, envy, jealousy, gossip, and all these things are promoted by this demon. Domestic violence, abuse, and raping, and all these things. Hallelujah. The next demon that is deadly is a demon, prince demon, I should say. All of them are prince demon. Is called Set, S-E-T. Set is the demon of death. Set is the demon of war, terrorism, rage, murder, blood shed, and violence. The next demon that you need to get over is Christian demon. Demon that camouflages themselves as one of us, but they are witches that have been camouflaged. God called us to be righteous. Christians must be able to detect those demons that come from the counsel of Satan, such as New Age, such as all these new entities that are coming in the church, the apostate church, the Antichrist church, not the church of the living God. So once you have power over these seven divisions of hell, this principality that comes to kill and destroy, you are going to be successful in your endeavor. At this time, we're going to battle. Are you ready? We're going to battle because there is a word of God over our lives. So there is a word of God, and we're asking the Lord, first, as I go up before him, in the courts of heaven, that every legions, I'm gonna call out the legions, hallelujah, the different departments that the legions are occupying. We're asking God to deliver us from the legions. Come on, somebody, are you there? Legions of sickness. After we have done our repentance and renunciation of lesions in us, our children, our husbands, and our wives, then we are ready to kick them out of our bodily system. Can somebody say, I agree in the prophetic name of Jesus tonight? Hallelujah. Praise God.
I agree in the prophetic name of Jesus Christ.
I agree in the prophetic name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Father, in the name of Yahushua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, the Son of God, I come to the courts of heaven by the shed blood of Yahushua HaMashiach. The first court I would like to go to is the court of Yahushua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, the anointed one. I come through the fire. I come through the blood. I dedicate my spirit to my Redeemer, who is the Prince of Lion of the Tribe of Judah Prophetic Worship Center. I dedicate my spirit and all of my humanity to you, the Lion of Judah. As we are going into this battle, I ask that the courts will be open according to Daniel chapter 7, 9, and 10. Roboshata Rebekusata, Hebrews 12, 1, 2, 1, 2. I ask, oh God, because we're in the 21st century era where spiritual warfare has escalated and the application of aggressive prayer is needed now more than ever. We ask, oh God, that every, hallelujah, as we come, the legions that seek totalitarian control over me, say it, I want you to repeat after me, I should say, sorry, over me and my children, my home, hallelujah, the organs of my body, hallelujah, because of spiritual ignorance, God, I was taken in captivity by the kingdom of darkness and by legions. I ask right now in the name of Jesus that you will summons my children, my entire bloodline on my mother's side, on my father's side, to the courts of heaven. Let the books be open right now in the mighty name of Yahshua HaMashiach, Jesus, the anointed one. Father, I ask in the name of Yahushua that every sin, God, of my bloodline that has opened the door to lesions, and God, I mean that's right from my beginning, where I first came into this earth, Lord, where the kingdom of darkness, hallelujah, may have established a trading floor where my destiny has been traded, my children's destiny has been traded, Father. We recognize that a diabolical trading floor where legions have traded us, where marrying spirit have come into us by the power of the Holy Ghost. I ask God that legions will be summoned right now to your court And as I begin, come on, child of God, repeat. As I begin to, hallelujah, to call the different names or the different realms of lesions, God, I ask that you will begin to silence them. Lesions from the marine kingdom, lesions of sickness, lesions of diseases, lesions of afflictions, lesions of debt and hell, lesions of witchcraft, sorcery, lesions of marine power, spirit husband, spirit wives, incubus and succubus, handekoshada, lilate and asmodai, asmodai, mighty God, lesions of satanic birds, lesions of premature death, lesions of demonic counter a copy like clones, legions of strong man, legions, God, of power of my father's house, legions of Kabbalah witchcraft, Kabbalistic witchcraft, legions, God, of witches and wizards that draw their power from the second heaven, from the cosmic, from the galactic, Rapakosekeya, Roboshataya, legions of serpent and scorpions, legions, God, that has taken up residence in my body, in my home, Mantabushatabikusete, for though I walk in the flesh, though, hallelujah, I wrestle not against flesh and blood, Lord. The weapon of my warfare are not carnal, but mighty to Yahushua Messiah, to the pulling down of stronghold, God. Legions of principality, legions of power, God. Legions of rulers of darkness against me, Lord. Wicked spirit in high places, God. I bring all the legions known and unknown to you, God. Known and unknown to me, but not known and unknown to you, God. Regions that have been taken over the regions of my body, God. Regions that are killers. Regions that are destiny altering. Regions that bring death. Regions that bring not only death to my humanity, but death to my destiny. Regions of accusation. Makabushi. Canto lebe katushai, roboko soto rebekusaya, legions from the covenants of Allah, the gates of Allah, the pit of Allah, the mouth of Allah, the arm of Allah. Kaboshadaba, the gates of hell, legions of the fallen sons of God, the profane sons of God, legions of the Nephilim, God of Elijah, Mantakushedebe Katusha. I begin to ask every covenant I have with legion that is a covenant of hell. I act on the word that comes out of your mouth, that all who call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. I renounce all dedication to all legions in the name of Jesus. Ungodly blood ritual, ungodly blood sacrifice, ungodly trading floor, an agreement, blood oath, blood alliance to legions of death, legions of sickness, by the power in the name of Jesus. Legion in my geographical realm, legion in my environment, legions, repeat it for yourself. I ask for forgiveness. I release the cross from the crown of my head to the sole of my feet. I release the work of the cross, the blood of the cross, the sacrificial blood of the Lamb, to go into me, to go into my bloodline. Mighty God, the perfect Lamb of God blood, the sacrificial offering for sin and iniquity of my humanity and that of my children and my bloodline on mother's side, Father, side, we ask for forgiveness of all iniquity and transgression, Jesus. We ask that you will totally nullify, obliterate all records of debt, all records of legal contract, covenant of debt, vows of debt, contract of debt, Holy Ghost, according to Colossians 2 verse 14, nailing it to the cross, spoiling principality. We ask that you will erase them, God. Now we summon all books of Hades on our organs, Holy Ghost, for there's a word of God on us. All books of Hades, all book of ownership, possession, entanglement, enslavement, in the name of Jesus, of lesions of our father's house and lesions of our mother's house, covenant of debt, covenant of sickness, covenant of demonic wounds, covenant of tragedy, covenant, God, we decree and declare the blood, we decree and declare the blood, the blood of the Lamb, to torment those internal demons, internal covenants of organ debt, organ killer, organ assassin, by the authority in the blood tonight. Any covenant that has dedicated our internal realm to these organ assassins for torment, for suicide, for destruction, for profane, hallelujah, profane dabbling in our internal realm, I stand as the ecclesia of the Most High God through the universal redemption of the blood. I appeal to the covenant of life. I appeal to the covenant of deliverance. I appeal, Rabba Kushede Karusabai, in the name of Jesus. I appeal to you, God. I appeal to you. Wherever any lesions of sickness, lesions, all the lesions that I called have dominion in me, in my bloodline, in my children, God of Elijah, I renounce the covenant. I break the contract. Rikabosata, mantakasata, any lesion, God, of shamanism, lesion of familiar spirit, lesion of black magic, lesion of mind control, lesion mantakusitare of sorcery, lesion acting my body, accusing my body, defiling my body, polluting my body, koshedebea, rababashanda, assigned to kill my body, God, by your authority, by your lordship, I summons them now by fire, by force, by fire, by force. Atu Shaba, Mendekatu, Roboshadaba. I engage you, Lord. I engage you, Lord. I engage you, my Father. I renounce all the lesions. I renounce their covenant. I pray in the name of Yahshua that they will have no more dominion over me, Makaboshata, generational spirit, marine spirit, witchcraft spirits that came down through my bloodline, witchcraft spirit that came through what was done in the sea, in the water, any dedication, anything committed against me, my children and bloodline coming from my father's house, I pray, God, that you will dry up their water, dry up their realm, dispossess their kingdom, hallelujah, shut their portals, block their gates, makakushikaya. Now, Father, every creature in me, mermaid spirit, sea creature, Father, I pray that they will be broken, they will be bound, they will be cast out of me, by the power, every demonic spirit, every witchcraft spirit in the name of Jesus, serpentine spirit, squid spirit, mind control spirit, water spirit, dry up the poured water in my body, any dragon spirit, python spirit, rain of fire and brimstone upon the dragon, rain fire and brimstone upon the black python, the serpent god, makabushi kantudubukusike. Come on, loose yourself and begin to pray in the spirit, just a little, bakasutu, rikabosanda, in the name of Yahshua. Begin to pray in the spirit. Bakabo Shende, Roboko Solo, Mandiria Shaya, Roboko Sanda, Victorio Sanda, Breaking Shada, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Cough it out and spit it out.
Don't swallow it. Shanto kosoto. Receive anointing. Receive anointing. Receive anointing for execration of that demonic spirit. Receive anointing. Be empowered by the power of the Holy Ghost. We're going to annihilate argon killers now. Hallelujah. Mute back your phone and repeat after me. Spear of the Lord, arise in your million and kill every argon assassin in my brain. Makashata. Hallelujah. Feel somebody, you're gonna cough out. This is a snake. It's a snake tying up your internal organ, like it wants to suffocate you. Pray the prayer point. Spear of the Lord, dagger of the Lord, razor of the Lord, come to my rescue. Come to my rescue. Come to my rescue. Say it again. Razor of the Lord, dagger of the Lord, come to my rescue. Begin to cut through the body of every organ killer assigned to my brain, assigned to my brain. We're gonna take it in stride from the head, go down to the tail. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. From the head, I should say, go down to your toes, not tail. Bakabushata. From the crown of your children's head, go down to their toes. Bakabushadabaha. We're releasing the apostolic sword tonight. Ah, yeah, yeah, yeah. Somebody's in trouble. Any argon assassin. You got to believe me, child of God. If you see them in the spirit, they are killers of argon. When they strike your argon, you hear that heart death, brain death. Hallelujah. Cardio failure. Death. They promote argon death because they're argon killer. Because there's a word of God over you, and the word cannot return void unto the Lord. It must accomplish what it was sent for to do, child of God. Get ready to shoot arrow in the camp of the enemy. Get ready to release judgment. Father, in the name of Yahushua, I cover the sword of God with the name of God tonight. We shall hit our target. Hallelujah. Sword of the Lord as given to Joshua in the book of Joshua. Javelin of the Lord appear right now. According to 1 Samuel 18:11. And Saul cast the javelin, for he said, I will smite David even to the wall with it. And David avoided him. Hallelujah. That day, I speak, God, the judgment of the Lord, as in Judges 5, verse 8. They choose new gods. Then was war in the gate. Was there not a shield? Was there not a spear seen among 40,000? Holy Boshandabaha. We summons, Lord, to the courts of heaven now. Mighty weapons of God in the sword of the Lord and the spear of the Lord. We ask that on the sword of the Lord and the spear of the Lord, the names of God will be applied, so we'll not miss our target. Jehovah Gibor, the man of war. Jehovah Gibor, that's your name. As we go into battle, show us kindness tonight. Take off Rabakusiketere, the demonic sigils, the demonic wards that blocks angelic intervention. Kadushabaha, we ask that you will use the spear of the Lord to smote the activity of Satan in the mighty name of Jesus. We're gonna start with the brain. Go straight down to the feet tonight. Are you ready, child of God? Spear of the Lord, arise in your power. Sword of the Lord, arise in your power. Come in your millions from the east, from the west, from the north, from the south, from above and below and around. I summons you into the battle. Any argon killer of my father's house in my respiratory system, my children's respiratory system, our digestive system. Come on, come on, come on. Spear of the Lord. Hallelujah. Sword of the Lord. Come in your mysterious power. Kill every argon killer from my father's house in my respiratory system, digestive system, cardiovascular system, renal system, endocrine system, nervous system, musculoskeletal system, lymphatic system, endocrine system, lymphatic system, immune system, my sexual reproductive system, my heart. Spear of the Lord, kill every organ killer in my children, reproductive system, respiratory system, cardiovascular system, endocrine system, nervous system, lymphatic, sexual system, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, raise up the Lord. Cut through every organ killer from my father's house, attacking the organs. Come on, child of God, get ready for battle. Robokonde kandedewosa. My father, release the spear of the Lord to kill every serpentine, scorpiontine, organ assassin from my father's house. A sign against me, Lord. A sign against my children. From the crown of my head to the sole of my feet. In the mighty name of Jesus. Some of you are going to start coughing. Argon assassin. A sign against my brain. A sign against my children's brain. What are you waiting for? Receive the spear of the Lord. Hallelujah. Say after me. Father, poison the spear of the Lord. Poison the spear of the Lord. Move now into battle, my father, with the spear of the Lord. Kill every argon assassin. Kill every mermaid spirit. Kill every serpentine spirit. Kill every crab. Kill every eel. Kill every octopus. Kill every squid of the marine kingdom. Kill every lyre. Kill them, God, by power, by fire. Kill every strong man from the marine kingdom. Kill them with the spear of the Lord. My father, kill every sea god, every sea goddesses, every monster, Halebo shatabakusa. Take the hook of the Lord mixed with the sword of the Lord and the dagger of the Lord and pull out the strong man from my brain. Pull out the dragon. Pull out the serpent. Pull out Leviathan. Mantakusa. Rebe Shatora. Bakushadaba. Bakushadaba. Come on. Fire of God. Fire of God. Excise the poison of organ killer from my blood. Somebody's coughing. Unmute your phone. You feel like something coming up? Halebo, who is that? Come on. Every poison out. Every poison out. I flush you in the blood of Jesus. Out in the name of Jesus. Spit out that poison. Out. Rabashi kondorosota. Rikabosota. Every poison in your blood out. Every poison in your brain out. Every poison in your lungs out. Out. Out in the mighty name of Jesus. Every poison in your blood out. Come it out. Spit. Those who are having poison coming out of their body, unmute your phone. I see 7 people online, 7 of you. Kishoto Rabaskaturia. Every poison out. Father, release anti-venomous blood. Flush out the poison. 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 Flush! Tell me what you're feeling inside of you, Kushata. All of those that are having poison execrated from your body now, unmute your phone. There are 7 of you that has been flushed now. I see you in the spirit.
Yes.
All right, you're gonna say after me, every poison, every venom of the organ killer in my blood, in my brain,
in my
back,
in my lungs,
in my heart, every venom, every poison of the organ killer,
Lord.
All right, I'm gonna let you mute back your phone so you can hear me, feel it coming out, just vomit it, and then we talk after. Mute back your phone. Say this after me. Every poison of the argon killers in my flesh. I excise you with the sword of the Lord, with the sword of the Lord, serpentine venom, scorpion-time venom, hallelujah, dragon venom, handobo sata, of the organ killers of my father's house, I flush you out. You're going to feel like you want to vomit, cough it out. I flush you out. By fire, I flush you out. I flush you out. I flush you out. Somebody's getting deliverance. I feel it. Yes, God. You serpent in the heart. Unwind, depart. Unwind, depart. Unwind, depart. Unwind, depart. Spit it out. By fire. Spit it out. By fire. Argon killers. From my father's house, a sign against my cardiovascular realm, my children's cardiovascular realm. What are you waiting for, you organ killer? Receive the sword of God. 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 Receive the sword of God in the prophetic name of Jesus. Where is the God of Elijah? Answer me by fire. Answer me by fire. Answer me by fire. Therefore, God, if the Son therefore shall make us free, we are free indeed. John 8:36. Therefore, you are gone killers of my Father's house. Spear of the Lord, sword of the Lord, dagger of the Lord. Penetrate the argon killer and kill them. Holy Ghost, release the dagger of the Lord, the spear of the Lord, against every argon killer that grips my brain, that grips my brain, that grips my brain, that grips my children's brain. In the name of Jesus, argon killers from my Father's house, from witches and wizards, from the coven of death, from the gates of hell. Argon killers, you are a liar. Release me by fire. Release me by, come on, child of God, you gotta pray it with fire. Every argon killer from my mother's house, from my father's house, holy bow shatter, from my neighborhood, on the job, argon killers, from the coven, from the cauldron, argon killers of serpents and scorpions, argon killers of the Illuminati, the Freemasonry, Alabashanda, argon killers, hallelujah, Baphomet, argon killers of Restitution Order, argon killers, Mantakusha, Bendekosa, argon killing strongman, argon killing prince, argon killing princess, argon killing generals, argon killing, hallelujah, evil ones, hallelujah, receive the spear of the Lord. Come on, you gotta pray, you gotta pray. Spirit of judgment, spirit of destruction, spirit of burning, accompanied by 3 billion packs of the horns of heaven. Locate the argon killers that wants to kill the kidney, that wants to kill the organs of the body, God. Boko shata, rikabo sata. Come on, child of God. I feel something in the realm of the spirit. Come on, the organs of your body that is under attack. There's a word of God over your life. What is the word? 1 John 1:2-3. Beloved, I wish above all things that as you prosper, your soul prosper and be in good health. Hallelujah. The organs, I feel the Holy Ghost, the organs that are under attack, every argon killer of your body, come out and die, come out and die, come out and die, come out and die, come out and die. Argon killers, come out, Baphomet, come out, Baphomet. Argon killers that grip the heart, that grip the cartilages, that grip the joints, that grip the nerves, that grip the arteries, that grip the cerebrum, that grip the liver, that grip the anus, that grip the vagina. Come on, child of God. Come on, there's something going on in the realm of the spirit right now. Argon killers, God. Argon killers, God. Roboshanti Kuriamanushkaya. Rebeko Soto. Come on, child of God. Hallelujah. We're going up higher. Lord, we need fire, fire. There are 78 organs in the human body. There are 78 organs in the human body, child of God. Argon killing strong man, argon killing lesions. You cannot survive this prayer. You cannot survive this prayer, devil. You must come out of our organs. Come on, child of God. Unmute your phone and say, you must come out Cough it out. It's not a part of your human component. It's a But we don't in the battle and we say, cough it out. You don't come for being dignified. Get out! It must come out. You're trespassing on God's property. It's not your body. Am I talking? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's a place to be dignified and there's a place to be undignified. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The battle has only just started. God promised me tonight that there will be deliverance on the line. Hallelujah. So we're going to specifically deal with the all 78 different parts of the body. And please don't just say it for yourself, your children. How many of you feeling deliverance so far? Huh? There's a word of God on my head. There's a word of God on my head. I cannot be bogged down by these demons. They got to let the vessel of God go so that God's vessel can be free to soar in realms of glory. Shout hallelujah in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So we're going to mute our phone. We're going to deal with
hallelujah.
This is very serious. We're going to deal with saints of God. Huh? The next level of prayer. Huh? I want you to pray it as if your life depends on it. Some of you are going to feel like you want to run to the toilet. Go. Yes, child of God. Let it go from you. Anywhere God, anyhow God chooses to execrate it from your body. It's your business and God. Come on, somebody. We're here to get deliverance, and that's what we're here for. Can somebody say a big amen? So I feel from my toe, my whole body feel like, you know what? God has God is up to something big tonight. When God hijacked the enemy like this, it's because he wants to bring reverential awe to his name. Amen, somebody. Just like all the enemy can hijack and ambush us, so we can hijack the devil. Hallelujah. I want us to give God glory tonight, child of God. Tonight is going to be one deliverance session. Some of you, even when you come up the line, you're going to still throw up. You're going to still pass out stuff. You know, God has placed that anointing on me. So the sister that her body was failing, hallelujah, from Pennsylvania, I want you to get the way to benefit from this kind of anointing is to put your phone, if you have a phone plug, in your ears, because we like to terrorize the internal enemies. I find that to be so much better when I'm having deep core deliverance sessions, when I always advise clients to get the phone in their ears. Hallelujah. We bombard the enemy on every side. And just like how he can enter the ear gate and build a stronghold there, so you can also terrorize him when he hears the different thing going into your realms. Your newer pathway, the old koshi of your newer pathway is being bombarded by God. We interrogate those strangers. So I'm going to say one more appeal to the Father, and then we are going to take them out of the 78 different parts of the human organs. There are five organs. They're among the whole bodily system. I need you to know that they are organs that work in coordination to different parts of your body. Several organ system among these 78 system in our bodies play such a significant role that, you know, if you lose these organs, you're dead. You understand? Your kidney is very vital, your liver, your lungs, all of these organs. If they stop functioning, it is very serious. Your heart, your brain, you cannot afford for organ killers to kill them, because you have a word of the Lord, and the word of the Lord must manifest over your life. In the name of Jesus, when these organs are under attack, they flow unhealthily, unable to maintain balance, no matter how adequately you sleep and diet. When your body is under physical attack by these demons in these different arena, you find out that no matter what I do, I am still not feeling myself. So we're gonna deal with them now. Please say after me, dear Lord Jesus, as I have confessed and renounce lesions, I specifically ask that the book of the lesions of organ assassin that has been deployed against me, my children, from my father's house, from witches and wizards, from my genealogical lineage on my mother's side, Father, I ask that all their accusation will be blotted out of my books. And I ask that all demonic sentence of organs death, organs decay, organs destruction will be nullified in Jesus' mighty name. So we're gonna pray. Spear of the Lord, dagger of the Lord, fire of the Lord, hallelujah, arise in your mysterious power and kill every organ assassin in my lungs, my children's lungs. Hallelujah. If you have husband and wife, arise, O Lord, with the spear of the Lord, the dagger of the Lord, the fire of the Lord. Kill all organ assassin in my arteries, my appendix, my adrenal gland, my brain, that of my children. Say it again. Arise, O Lord, in the firmament of your power. Release the spear of the Lord, the fire of the Lord, the sword of the Lord, against argon assassin deployed from my father's house, my mother's house, witches and wizards against me and my children. Capillaries, cerebrum, capillaries, joints, livers, our lungs, hallelujah, our ears, our eyes, our bones, our brains. Can you say it again? Oh Lord, arise with your sword, with your spear, with the fire of God, and kill every organ assassin deployed against me and my children, joints, nerve, skin, our skin, our tendons, our arteries, our cerebrum, our livers, navel cavity, our spleen, our tongue, our appendix, diaphragm, lungs, our ovary, our scrotum, our thyroid gland, adrenaline gland, our ears, halaboshanda, our stomach, our thalamus gland, pineal gland, penis and vaginas, ligaments, ears and brain, bones, fallopian tube, lip node, begin to kill all organ assassin. Come on, child of God. In my brain, my children's brain, oh Lord, with your sword, with your spear, begin to kill all organ assassin. In my capillaries, my children's capillaries, our joints, begin to kill organ assassin. In my nerves and my children's nervous system, begin to kill organ assassin. In my skin, organ assassin. In my tenders, organ assassin. In my tendons, I should say, arteries, cerebrum. In my livers, that of my children, navel cavity, spine and spleen, scrotum, thyroid gland, ligaments, vagina, lip node, fallopian tube, penis, pancreas, small intestine. Oh God, arise, begin to kill all organ killers. In my uterus, bone, canicle, genital, large intestine, saliva gland, in my urethra, Lord God, begin to kill organ assassin. In my gallbladder, my bladder, my lymphatic vessel, my placenta, my skeleton muscular system, my uterus, my bone marrow, God. Oh God, arise and kill organ assassin. In my heart, my children heart, our mouth, our prostate, hallelujah, seminal visceral, vulva, our colon, hallelujah, our ear follicles, our pineal gland, our subcutaneous tissues, our vein, our teeth, our pituitary gland, our mammary gland, our cervix, our nose, our pituitary gland, our tonsils, our vaginal vestigial glands and organ, kidney, clitoris, nail, rectum and testicle, hypothalamus gland. Oh God, with your sword, begin to kill all these aliens, all these entities in these glands. Come on, somebody. Where is the lady now from Philadelphia whose organ is failing? Come online. In the name of Yahshua, Hindukusata. Quickly, unmute your phone, child of God. Unmute your phone. Come on, in the fire. Don't wait until the fire go down. Hallelujah. Unmute your phone. Say after me. With your spear, oh God, kill every power that wants me to die, that wants my organs to die. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
And kill every power that wants me to die, that wants my organs to die, that
I just
wants
want the
my skin to die, that wants my body, my soul, and my spirit to die. Kill every.
Can we give the lady from Philadelphia? You can mute your phone, let her unmute because her situation is critical. Please.
Yes, I'm here, prophetess.
Say, oh Lord.
Oh Lord, every organ killers,
denying me of the rightful use of my organs, arise, oh Lord, and kill every organ assassin,
and kill every organ assassin
assigned to my nervous system. Assigned to my liver and my kidney.
Assigned to my liver and my kidney.
I see problem with your kidney.
Yes, I'm on dialysis.
Yes, okay. Say, oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
Every organ assassin.
Every organ assassin.
That has created a timeline.
that has created a timeline.
For me to die.
For me to die.
You organ assassin.
You organ assassin.
You are a liar.
You are a liar.
Now, if you have faith, you will come off of that dialysis machine. Say exactly what I am going to say right now. Oh, Lord, I repent.
Oh, Lord, I repent.
Of every accusation.
Of every accusation.
From the occult world.
From the occult world.
A sign against my kidneys.
A sign against my kidneys.
Every man and every woman.
Every man and every woman.
That have offered my kidneys.
That has offered my kidneys.
As a sacrifice.
As a sacrifice.
To demonic gods.
To demonic gods.
I repent in the name of Jesus.
I repent in the name of Jesus.
And ask for your blood.
And ask for your blood.
Wash me and make me clean.
Wash me and make me clean.
I ask that every sentence of judgment.
I ask that every sentence of judgment.
Death and sickness.
Death and sickness.
Will be erased from my books.
Will be erased from my books.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Oh, you must say this with all your heart. Argan assassin.
All guys of ecstasy.
Argan, organs, organs, O-G-A-N.
Organs of assassin.
Assigned to my kidneys.
Assigned to my kidneys.
Your time is up.
Your time is up.
Receive the spear of the Lord.
Receive the spear of the Lord.
And die.
And die.
I smash.
I smash.
And the head of the rock of. I smash the head. I smash the head.
I smash the head.
Of every serpent.
Of every serpent.
Every dragon.
Every dragon.
Assigned to kill.
Assigned to kill.
The organs of my body.
The organs of my body.
That every python.
That every python.
Piling around my internal organs.
Crawling around my eternal organs.
I break your head.
I break your head.
Serpentine assassin.
Serpentine assassin.
Assigned to sting my organs to death.
Assigned to sting my organs to death.
Loose your covenant.
Loose your covenant.
And go.
And go.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The strong man of total body death.
The strong man of total body death.
Your time is up.
Your time is up.
My body is the temple of the Lord.
My body is the temple of the Lord.
Every covenant you have on my body.
Every covenant you have on my body.
For total body death.
Total body death.
Total body decay.
Total body decay.
I break you and I scatter that covenant.
I break you and I scatter that covenant.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This is what I see. I see 3 years was allotted to you and you would deteriorate. But the Lord is extending your days. Can you shout hallelujah? Because there's a word of God on your head. You will not die untimely in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
So we're coming to the last point of mute back your phone. I feel so revived. I hope you're all feeling what I am feeling. I feel like a million bucks today. The anointing is just swooning over my soul. Can you all unmute your phone? There's 3 more prayer points that you must say. Prayer point number 1, every covenant with organ killers. From my father, just vomit it out. Don't do it right now. I'm praying. Vomit it, cough it out, and spit it out. Can my host mute everyone, please? Right now. Let me say these prayer points. These prayer points are very important. Prayer point number 1 is said, every covenant with organ killers is the same thing as organ assassin. Of my father's house, of my ancestors on mother's side and father's side, break by the blood of the Lamb. Every covenant with organ killers from my father's house, from my mother's house, all my ancestry, break by the covenant of the blood of the Lamb. Every poison in my body by organ killers, because there's a word of God on my life, you no longer have dominion and authority over me. I bear in my body the mark of the Lord Jesus. Let no demon pollute me or trouble me in Jesus' name. Prayer point number three, argon assassin, waiting until I sleep to struck my organs with sicknesses and infirmity. I release on you the unquenchable fire of God. Be destroyed in Jesus' name. The last one. Oh Lord, every legions of argon assassin deployed against my internal realm, that of my children, let them be apprehended, pierced, and thrust out of me, chained into everlasting fire until the day of judgment. I seal my prayers with the blood and with the fire of God. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Somebody shout hallelujah in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What has the Lord done for you on this broadcast? Can you tell us? What has the Lord done for you on this broadcast? Is there anyone?
Good Hallelujah. Morning. Good night. Good night, Apostle.
Glory to God.
Good night, Apostle.
Good night. Glory to God.
And everyone. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Apostle, the word, you're so on point. I woke up this morning, and when I woke up, my body was all over in pain.
Yes.
In my back. All over from my head go right down. I was in pain. Mm-hmm. And I get up and I say, Lord Jesus. And then I was just peeing the blood. And since I'm online, I'm in my back. But since I'm online and I'm saying the prayer points and I'm just, you know, moving up my body and just saying the prayer points, I want to tell you, I feel much better.
God be the glory. Better. Can I tell you something?
Yes, Apostle.
God wants us to exercise our authority. You know, Satan is not going anywhere until Jesus comes. You understand?
Yes.
He leaves you for a season. So we must never, never give up. The scripture admonishes us that men ought to pray all sorts of prayer. Die by fire. Get out. You know, you just pray all sorts of prayer and you are not afraid. But I want you to get total deliverance. Can you say, argon assassin?
Hey. Argon assassin. Of witchcraft coven.
Fired in my body.
Fired in my body.
What are you waiting for?
What are you waiting for?
Jump out and die.
Jump out and die.
Put your hands in your navel. Argon assassin.
Argon assassin.
From the cauldron of death.
From the cauldron of death.
Receive the sword of fire.
Receive the sword of fire.
And die.
Woo. And die.
Every satanic octopus.
Every satanic octopus.
Every satanic squids.
Every satanic squids
from the marine kingdom,
from the marine kingdom.
Poisoning my body.
Poisoning my body.
I set you ablaze.
I set you ablaze.
Melt like wax.
Melt like wax.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Say this with all your might. Argan assassin Goliath.
Argan assassin Goliath.
Argan assassin strong man.
Argan assassin strong man.
Receive the sword of fire.
Receive the sword of fire.
And die.
And die.
Not hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you.
You know hallelujah. What I see? The Lord show me that he raised you up as such a profound, high level prayer warrior. Your main assignment will be now to deal with sorcerers and diviners, because God will allow them to show up until you take authority. If you don't have word to say, like you, that sorcery, just say, Father, let the blood begin to execrate judgment upon sorcerer, because the blood bring good result and the blood also bring judgment. You can release the blood against diviners activities, familiar spirit activities, sorcerers activities, because it is the end time and God can never bring you into ministry without you having to deal with these things, because part of the end time ministry will be about witchcraft. It will be so much more dominant in the end time than we have ever seen it. So get ready, saggy your riding. Don't loosen your momentum in prayer. Keep in the word and keep living a holy life. And you, many people don't know that it's the life that you live that causes it to have effect in the spirit. Satan is not moved by your shout. He's not even moved by how much you know the word, because he knows the Bible too. It was from Matthew chapter 4, he tempted Jesus. So you must live a life that way. He said, get out, get out. You don't have to say it 5, 6, 7 times. Because he understands authority, and you live a life that when you speak the word of God, heaven back what you say. And that's where the victory is at. Amen. Hallelujah. Anyone else want a glorious night tonight? Hallelujah.
Good night, Apostle. While you were praying, I have been throwing up a lot of throw ups. And I just want to give God praise and thanks for his deliverance on my life tonight.
And so I decree and declare that even as you come off this line, you will be able to discern the enemy's manipulation. You will be able to command manipulative forces of darkness to melt like us. God don't want you to fall and roll over. Can you mute the background so we can talk so it won't be interrupted? There's no way that God want you to just lie down and roll over and let the enemy come in and kill you. No, you got to get up on, hallelujah, the authority of the word of God in you, and utilizes the weapon that God has given to you. Remember that God is the mighty man of battle in you. So no cauldron can take you out. You got to enforce the word of the Lord. Now, when I was coming on, God told me that even though I'm going to talk about the word, it's going to culminate in the Argan assassin. He showed me that there are many people on this line and that is watching me globally, that their organs are under attack by Argan killers. That means these entities are on assignment, just like gunmen, terrorists, robbers. Their assignment, their spiritual terrorists, their assignment is to kill the organs of your body. Some of them have been hired, and some of them you acquire them through captivity. You go to a place, an organ assassin were there, and they just cleave to you. They have a grip on you. So that's the way to go. If you want your brain to start function, oh God, every organ assassin assigned to my nervous system, assigned to my brain, assigned to my heart, begin to release the fire of God, the spear of the Lord, and say it with faith, because they're hearing you. They know when you're saying it in faith from when you doubt what you're saying. Amen. Anyone else?
Thank you, Apostle. God bless you.
Thank God for the deliverance. Amen. Anyone else want to go? I'm not going to stay online.
Yeah, anyone I'm good now.
Anything? We want to do it expeditious. Come on, just do it quickly. Go ahead.
Yeah, good night. Yeah, good night. Actually, I fall asleep, but I wake up in the last part. So I just like to do a quick recite.
I didn't hear what you say. You wake up what?
Yeah, I wake up in the last ending.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because I fall asleep. So I just like to do a quick recite.
You would like a quick recite?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, you'd have to liaise with Minister Davis and Minister.
No, man, in terms of a quick prayer.
Oh, there's no way I can go back all of that. Oh, you could never come on a battlefield and fall asleep. That's your fault. You're going to have to get the playback. You're going to have to get the playback and do the prayer all by yourself. Hallelujah. Mm. Paul was having a session and a man fall asleep in the hall of Paul's preaching and he dropped down dead. So they had to raise him back to sleep. You can never go on the battlefield and fall asleep. We are not responsible for you when you fall asleep. Anyone else, please? That was fascinating. Did anyone else
good night, Apostle.
But there was so much fire.
Yes, Apostle. Good night. Minister Dave here.
Yes, sir.
Before you started to do the prayer points, I started to do some belching and, you know, passing wind and,
yes,
you know, so much things going on with me. You know, I was a vomiting per se, but, you know, I had some stuff coming up, you know, some slimy stuff, you know, and I'm just giving God thanks for this word.
Yeah.
You know, because there's so much things that I know that the enemy has sowed into my life, you know, from a young stage until now, and God is just giving the release. You know, God has sent a timely word such as this for us to be free. So I'm just giving thanks for my deliverance tonight in Jesus' name.
Do you know what I want to say? I've been a deliverance minister for 15 years, and spirit comes out of us different ways. Some people just find tears rolling down their eyes uncontrollably, yawning, flatulence, vomiting, defecation, urination. Some people start to sweat profusely out of their skin. So depending on what kind of demon is in your body, it comes out a different way. But I want you to say this. I need the five prayer points I'm giving you. Organ assassin from my father's house.
Organ assassin from my father's house.
I release the razor of the Lord.
I release the razor of the Lord.
Hallelujah. I release the spear of the Lord.
I release the spear of the Lord.
And I kill you in the name
of Jesus. And I kill you in the name of Jesus.
Every habitation.
Every habitation.
Of organ killers. In my nervous system.
In my nervous system.
In my anus.
In my anus.
Ikorobo. Bakatarabasoto. Robokosotobaha. In my colon gland.
In my colon gland.
Your time is up.
Your time is up.
Receive the sword of fire and die.
Receive the sword of fire and die.
I set unquenchable fire.
I set unquenchable fire.
Upon witchcraft organ killers.
Upon witchcraft organ killers.
Residing in my body.
Residing in my body and my children's body. Jesus.
Every habitation
of witchcraft assassin
assigned to kill the organs of my body. Loud and clear, because there's a word of God.
Jesus.
upon my life.
Hallelujah.
You shall not kill my body.
You shall not kill my body.
And die in the name of Jesus. Come on, man of God, you got to say this. You got to say this.
Every habitation
of witchcraft assassin.
Of witchcraft assassin.
Assigned to kill me.
Assigned to kill me.
And the organs of my body.
And the organs of my body.
Because there's a word of the Lord.
Because there's a word of the Lord.
Upon my life.
Upon my life.
I shall not die.
Woo! I shall not die.
But live to declare.
But live to declare.
The word of the Lord.
The word of the Lord.
Therefore, you organ killers.
Therefore, you organ killers.
I set your habitation ablaze.
I set your habitation ablaze.
With the fire of God.
With the fire of God.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Organ assassin.
Every organ assassin.
In my environment.
In my environment.
Harassing the organs of my body.
Harassing the organs of my body.
Angels of death.
Angels of death.
Locate them and kill them.
Locate them and kill them.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah.
If you can continue this, just do it for a couple of days. You will see. And I know when we go, you're going to go hard.
Huh?
Deal with the organ killers of the brain, of the heart, of every gland in your body that you just call them on. Organ assassin residing in this era. Your time is up. There's a word of the Lord on my life. You cannot kill me. Up and out. And I
in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God bless you, man of God.
God bless you, Apostle.
Good night, Apostle.
Good night.
I just want to say God bless you for your prayer points. Yes. Even a while ago when you were saying them, when you were asking Minister Dave to repeat them, goosebumps just start full all over my body.
Yes.
And from the other day, as I told you, from the last time you send your prayer points,
yes,
in the group, you've been saying them, and the dreams that I was getting, as which I voice note you.
Yes.
Your prayer is just so powerful. And I even tell myself, even before I go to go court on Friday, I'm going to repeat it.
No,
I texted me.
Do you know that this prayer point is potent? Because it was an organ assassin come to kill you with knife. Huh? So this is your message tonight. Huh?
Yes.
I want you to say these three prayer points and watch what happened in the court tomorrow. Say confusion in the courthouse.
Confusion in the courthouse.
Programmed by witchcraft.
Programmed by witchcraft.
Rock of Gibraltar.
Rock of Gibraltar.
Swallow them.
Swallow them.
Before I continue, let me give you a testimony. This lady, she wrote me today. I tell her to send a testimony for those that will come online. I was in a very high realm in the prophetic, and she wrote me and she said she need prayer. And when I was praying for her, I hear the spirit of murder. I heard murder. God says to me, take authority over the spirit of murder. I said, wow. I said, God, the spirit of murder. He said, yes. Then the Lord began to tell me that this woman in question, she did a business with a man, and the man don't want to, it's a car she asked him to buy, and the man don't want to pay her back. She didn't get the car, and he don't want to pay her back her money. Okay, so here is the testimony. All right. She said, I want to give God praise for his mercy and wonder working power. I had a case in the court with someone who robbed me and tried to get away. The police caught him and charged him, so he was forced to go to court. Knowing that he was a criminal and may harm me, I asked prophetess to pray for me. She prophesied that he did intend to kill me through witchcraft and physical violence because he had no intention of repaying me. She prayed for me and I attended the court and got back home safely. Thanks be to God for his divine protection and obedience. This case is not over, but we're reporting victory. To God be the glory.
Amen. And so
many people don't understand the power. Some people undermine prophets' ministry. And when prophets speak and you things happen and you don't testify, then guess what? Your thing is not made perfected. You can ask Jesus in the second book of St. Matthew. There was 10 lepers, right? And only one came back to say, well, so and so. And so you have people want to hide the testimony, and those are the people that I'm going to stop praying for. Because you continue, come and you receive and you receive. And no matter what God does for you, we will never hear the testimonies. You keep it locked and you're just milking the prophet and milking. You are discouragers. When God do something, we come and we celebrate it. It was right on this platform. God gave me a prophecy that four wedding. Minister Dave, are you there? And those from out of worship. And
I was here when you prophesied about it, prophetess. I was here when you was telling them that
there will be four weddings. There will be four weddings in Art of Worship in 2022. It could not be a coincidence that this week we embark upon the final wedding. And I'm sure God is going to do much more. But he brought his word to pass. Yes. If somebody call me and tell me that, prophetess, you remember the prophecy you gave us that four wedding will be in Art of Worship for 2022, I said, well, you know, because you don't really sit down and memorize prophecy. When God give you prophecy, you release prophecy. To date, four marriages has taken place. You find prophet come and they're discouraged because some of you get deliverance and you pretend like nothing is going on. So for you, I gave your word that they will have to be a sacrament. And I saw first that they wanted to give you $1 million, which I tell you should negate it. Did you remember that?
Yes, you did call me and ask me how much I want. When I tell you, you said you would get back to me, but you didn't get back to me.
All right. So God wants you not to just get $1 million.
Okay.
It's not that. But what I'm going to tell you, the truth, what I see. The woman that attempt to kill you, she don't have no money. So it's going to be based on you to settle, to come up with a settlement. Whether you're going to ask the judge that she pay up the $1 million up front she must document, she must state that the rest of the money is forthcoming, because I see $3 million in the realm of the spirit, but she really don't have it. 3 to 5 million. Okay,
so yes, Professor, when the judge did say how much, and I said 10, she was saying that she didn't have it, and I take it all the way down to 5. And that was the time when I call you and I tell you that she was offering $1 million.
I said 3 to 5 million. So even if she cannot pay that, you gotta say to your lawyer, whoever is presenting you, if she can't pay the 5 million, you can take installment agreement. But there's no way under God she's going to pay $1 million for almost taking your life and just go back and sit back. She's not feeding a dog. She's going to pay up that 3 or 5 million. Or she's going to jail. I'm finished talking. Next person. Perfect.
Thank you.
Anyone else? There's any more time. Are we going to close
out? Another pastor.
Good night.
Yes. I only just want
to just want to give God thanks for tonight, for the word. I received it. I there's a lot of things in the message that's pertaining to me, and I'm just giving God thanks for the word. And there's a lot of deliverance I'm getting. I'm still going through the process, so I'm giving God thanks for deliverance. There's some taste that coming up in my mouth. There's like the slimy stuff, and there's some bitter taste. Like when you mentioned the part about the poison part.
Try not to swallow that bitter taste.
Yes, mm-hmm. I am.
It has something to do with the gastric liquid inside of you. Be careful, okay?
Yes.
Things like cider. Just go into alkaline water for now, because this is the gastric acid coming up, and that's not good. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Don't swallow the bitterness. But what I see for you, beloved, I see it. I see a strong man that was sitting on your head. And that strong man was monitoring all the organ assassin. They try you 1, 2, 3 times. So now you're going to have to take this as a personal prayer to debunk all organ assassin from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet. You must do as long as it takes. When you're vomiting, it just shows you that there's more thing to come out. So many people just say, I vomit, and there's always a root. That when that root comes out, sometimes it comes in a plot of blood or fleshy looking thing. When I mean all core deliverance, and you know that, can you work with
yes.
me?
Yes, ma'am.
Vomit out blood, thick blood, you know that is the strong man coming yes. out. Good for you to take this prayer point and run with it and deal yes. with an assassin in you and your family.
Yes, ma'am.
For you feel. From I start dealing, you feel like a recalibration just come upon you, because yes. the organ assassin, if they can kill you, like suddenly, they will take time, irritate, irrigate, break down the flesh. Their aim is for total annihilation. But yes. depending on your strength, some of them cannot do it on a one attack. They will do it over a period of time. So get into work, woman of God. I'm with you in this.
Amen. Thank you, ma'am. Yeah. Appreciate it. Yes, God bless you.
After this.
Good night. Good night, yeah. Apostle.
Good night.
Mr. Carolyn Dorset there?
Yes, right here, Prophetess. You know, today I was, and not just today, also yesterday, I've been praying, you know, and I kept saying, Lord, defend your interest in my life and in Hunter's life, especially Hunter's life.
Yes.
And I kept saying that your word must manifest in his life, and everything that you've said for him is going to come true. It must come true in the name of Jesus. And I've been saying it since yesterday. He couldn't even get out of the bed almost. Today he was alive and well, walking around school like nobody's business. You know, he had a little bit of pain, you know, but he was a whole lot better than yesterday.
We're gonna do this. Where is he?
Right here.
Listen, I am telling you, it's an organ killer.
Someone is trying to kill me. I had this is the worst pain.
I know, you don't have to tell me. I called your mother, I saw it. So what, why they're trying to kill you until everything was all right until they start to go to pilot school, till they start to learn other things, and there are other people that don't want you to outrun them. In your achievement. So here I have 5 prayer points I want to pray. For the rest of this year, this is the prayer point you're going to pray. I'm telling you, even if you feel like you're dying when you pray this prayer point, continue to pray. Huh? Because what they want to give you is an heart attack, sudden death. I tell Sister Caroline already. Didn't I tell you?
Yeah.
So here is a prayer point. Oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
I humble myself before you.
I humble myself before you.
I ask for forgiveness of any sin.
I ask for forgiveness for any sin.
And open the door to this attack.
And open the door to the.
That open
the door. That open the door for this attack.
I will ask, listen, close your eyes. Just listen to what I'm saying and repeat it with everything that is in you. You don't have to feel anything right away, but these things that are attacking you, they are spirits. So I'm going to say this, number one. Say this one first. Every organ killer.
Every organ killer.
Assigned to my heart.
Assigned to my heart.
Say spear of the Lord.
The spear of the Lord.
Released in the belly.
Released in the belly.
Of this organ killer.
Of the organ killer.
Say organ killer.
The organ killer.
Of my father's house.
My father's house.
Assigned to kill me before my time.
Assigned to kill me before my time.
Fear of the Lord.
Fear of the Lord.
Destroy them.
Destroy them.
To every agenda.
To every agenda.
Of organ killing powers.
Organ killing powers.
Upon my heart.
Upon my heart.
Be destroyed.
Be destroyed.
Carolyn?
Yes.
Place your hand on his chest. Both of you stay together. Every witchcraft organ killer.
Every witchcraft organ killer.
Assigned to Hunter's heart.
Assigned to my Hunter's heart.
By the power in the blood of Jesus.
By the power in the blood of Jesus.
I cancel your assignment.
I cancel your assignment.
To every witch.
Every witch.
Invoking the heart of Hunter.
Invoking the heart of me.
Let the blood of Jesus.
Let the blood of Jesus.
Let the fire of God.
Let the fire of God.
Kill them.
Kill them.
It's a witchcraft affliction.
Witchcraft affliction.
Assigned to Hunter's heart.
Assigned to my Hunter's heart.
By the power of darkness.
By the power of darkness.
You are a liar.
You are a liar.
Die by fire.
Die by fire.
Now this one is going to cause serious problem in the camp of darkness. It's every eater of flesh.
Every eater of flesh.
And drinkers of blood.
And drinkers of blood.
Assigned to eat down Hunter's heart.
Assigned to eat down Hunter's heart.
Fire of God.
Fire of God.
Destroy them.
Destroy them.
The super blood of Jesus.
Super blood of Jesus.
Incubate Hunter's heart.
Incubate Hunter's heart.
Now I want you to say this very serious. Every electromagnetic. Electrical radiation. Witchcraft vampirism. Assigned to Hunter's heart. O Lord, arise.
O Lord, arise.
With your electromagnetic angels. And destroy them. So, Caroline, here's what you're going to do. You're going to say, Oh, Lord. Put a Faraday cage. Over Hunter's heart. And seal it. With an impenetrable shield. In Jesus' name.
Jesus' mighty name.
I saw a witch. Is a woman doing this, not a man. Is a female doing this. I saw his heart being summoned. Only prayer can help you. You got to stay on it in prayer. You will be fine. They want to kill him, so we cannot get light on prayer. And all of this come because of his achievement. Amen? Nothing like this ever happened to him before, all because of his achievement. That's why they want to kill him. So we're gonna continue lift them up. I'll talk to you off the line about some other stuff. Next call, please. We're coming down. Wonderful. Anyone else?
Yes, I just want to report one victory tonight. You know, I have been battling with these organ killers. But there was this hold on my heart that I couldn't shift. And during the prayer, it has shifted.
So shout hallelujah.
I give God thanks tonight.
Sister Rose, you were the first one I saw when the Lord gave me argon killers.
Yes, ma'am.
I said, how am I going to bring the two words them into one? Because you told me specifically that you want to talk about the manifestation of the word. He said, dead people can't get word manifest. You must deal with argon killer. So I have 10 prayer points for you. Are you ready? I'd like to pray with
yes.
you.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Argon killers.
Argon killers.
Assigned to my heart.
Assigned to my heart.
From the coven and the cauldron of death.
From the coven and the cauldron of death.
I cancel your verdict.
I cancel your verdict.
I kill your power base. Aye, aye, aye.
Kill your power base. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah.
Jesus Christ is Lord. They have come to see what's going on. Worship the Lord, worship the Lord, worship
glory
the Lord.
Glory to God. I praise and I adore you, Lord, and glorify your grace. You are worthy of praise and adoration, my God. And bless your name, Lord, because there is none like unto you, Jesus. I praise your great and holy name. Hallelujah to your name, Lamb of God. Hallelujah to your name, eternal God. I praise and I adore you and I glorify your matchless name tonight. Glory and honor and praise and dominion and power belong to you forevermore. Hallelujah. Glory to your name, Jesus. Glory to your name, Lord. I praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to your name forevermore. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
The Lord says, Sister Caroline Dorset, everybody that ever I pray for, take this too. The Lord says you need to kill their power base. That's when the anointing explored on me. The power base is their realm of operation. The power base is where the attack is manufactured from. The power base is their source of power. Shout hallelujah. In the name of Jesus.
Glory
hallelujah.
To God. Glory to God.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Say, I keep from your killer power base, you don't have to send the 10 prayer point.
Yes. Glory to God.
So witchcraft as argon assassin.
Witchcraft organ assassin.
Assigned against my heart.
Assigned against my heart.
I bomb up your power base.
I bomb up your power base.
In the name of Yahshua.
In the name of Yeshua. Hallelujah.
And again, witchcraft
organ assassin.
Assigned against my heart.
Assigned against my heart.
I blow up your power base.
Blow up your power base.
With the fire of destruction.
With the fire of destruction.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Anointing coming to the word. Well, I'm not
thank you, Jesus.
And the last thank person, you. We're going home now. Woo-hoo, Jesus.
Hello, Pastor. Good night.
Ooh, we thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hello.
Yes, beloved, go ahead.
Good night.
Yes, beloved, go ahead.
Yes, Apostle. Last night I get a vision, and in my vision, Art Worship End Time Ministry is my ministry. This is Sister Charlene.
Yes, Sister Charlene.
And in the vision, because first and second we have a prayer meeting on the line last night, and after that prayer meeting finished, I just go straight to our bed. And in the vision, a pastor, I saw a holy tabacker. You know, they make a holy power, it's a circle. And my church sisters them was also praying for me, because Sister Kendra in the vision was saying to me, said, Sister Shirley, you alone have to mash up back. Apostle, the amount of back, glory be to God. And honestly, God help me, not me. God help me to destroy every buckle. I start shoot up every buckle. I just start shoot them up. Everything and everything what I shoot, none missing, Apostle. All of them just mash up the buckle. Just mash up, mash up, mash up.
Do you know what that means?
I kind of understand the vision is like God was just mashing up all the trap what them set from me, all the buckle, every mouth.
The buckle and cage.
Okay.
The buckle and cage. Human souls were caged in those bottles. That's why God break them and liberate those who were caged.
Okay.
Runs in the prophetic, when you come up against bottles in the vision, unless it's bottle where you get an anointed oil or being anointed from, it always represent cages, witchcraft cages, human soul being caged. So that's a very good dream, woman of God. Keep up the good work in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I wanna go now, because I feel that this is something that I'm going to ask our host, please, to send me the broadcast. We have so much people that needs to pray this prayer, inclusive of the lady in Philadelphia, who her body was literally shutting down. I think she needs to continuously pray, you know, maybe for a season before she get total emancipation from all these organ killers that is after her body. We have come to the end of this wonderful night in the Holy Spirit. As always, I am always excited. God is so faithful, and I give him thanks for everything in Jesus' mighty name. Next week, I celebrate, by God's grace, on the 24th of October. The next 4 days, I will be celebrating my 50th birthday. I do not want anyone to buy me any presents. If you want to reach out to me with a love offering, or, you know, that is the only thing I accept. The reason for that, people have made several attempts to kill me. So I don't take gifts from no one, even if you're pastor or prophet. People have attempted to poison me, to do me all kind of stuff. So the Lord told me not to accept any gift. If you want to be a blessing to me, you can reach out to me and I will give you the relevant information and all. You can be a blessing to the prophet of God. Yahweh bless you. Thank you so much. Now unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us blameless before a glorious appearance, for the ever wise God, Yod-Eh-Vad-Eh, be glory, honor, dominion, and power. And all God's children say, amen. I hand over to my host in Jesus' name.
Blessings. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So, Apostle, we just want to thank you once again, you know, for spending time in the Word, and as God has given you directive that you spend time with us, you know, to deliver this Word, you know, to empower us. And you are a channel of blessing to us. And before you go, we just want to declare God's blessing upon your life. in the name of Jesus. And we just decree and declare that God will set up ambushments against every plot and scheme of the enemy to come against your life in the name of Jesus. And we declare the word that says no weapon formed against you will ever be able to prosper. And every tongue that rise up against you in judgment is condemned. Even now, every device of the crafty is exposed, nullified, canceled, inoperative, even now in the name of Jesus. We just release angels, hallelujah, glory to God, heavenly hosts to surround you like a shield. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, wherever you go, the mark, the blood of Jesus is upon your life. You shall live and not die, but you shall live to declare the works of God in the name of Jesus. I pray even now that the Lord has given you the necks of your enemy.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, that
hallelujah,
you may tread them under. Robocosata, woman of God, they shall surely gather together, but it was not a plan of the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In the name of Jesus, for the Lord will scatter them, expose them, and bring them to shame.
That's
in the
what
name
he's doing.
Of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You will see and know who your enemies are in the
that
name
is the truth.
Of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Echo Robocosata. There have been some close ones to you in the name of Jesus, but they are leaving you in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Father, even now, Almighty God, your word says the plans that you have for Apostle is to do her good. And I decree and declare that your ministry is ahead, Rabakasata. It has the backing of Yeshua, Ekoba, Asia, Europe, Echo to Rebecca Sata. Wherever your mind has thought about where you want to deliver the gospel, you shall possess the land in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. That promise, Ekobo Sata. In the name of Jesus, Hakurobo Sata. In the name of Jesus, as the man of God said, give me this mountain, you will accomplish it. Apostle Echo Robo Koshanda. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And we cut off all forms of accusation, jealousy, Echo Rebeko Shata against you now. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we cut it off by fire of the Holy Ghost. Burn down every tree, echo every order, every coven, echo Sata, every evil altar, Makobo, against the woman of God, Rakobo Shikebe Sete. And we come in agreement, because the word of God says one chaseth a thousand, but two, three, four, five, 50. When we come together, we put more than 10,000 to flight. In the name of Jesus, every promise that the Lord has promised you will come to fruition in the name of Jesus. You lack no good and needful thing, woman of God. You don't have to beg for anything. You just whisper it. You just think upon it. As the word says, think on these good things. The Lord will establish it in your life. In a short space of time, woman, we're not saying months, we're not saying years, the Lord will do a new thing as you think it. The Lord will bring it to pass. We give you thanks, Almighty God. We give you thanks. The blood of Jesus covers you from the very crown of your head to the very sole of your feet. Woman of God, the enemy goes around like a roaring lion. But God says, I give life, I give you life, and life more abundantly. So we thank you, Father. We declare it done.
We declare Lion of Judah prophetic, blessed God, every office, God, because you're raising her up to raise up prophets, apostles in the name of Jesus. We thank you that they're a cutting edge ministry. They call Shata Bako Sata, everyone in training, God, Ikutu Rebecca Sata, bears the mark and bears the mystery of God in them.
Amen.
We thank you, Abba Father. We declare it done in Jesus' mighty name.
Awesome. Hallelujah. That was an awesome prayer. And just want to confirm, God has been cutting away some people. They are wicked. They are users. They are mockers. So I'm always alone. I like to be by myself. I love my company. I am a no-nonsense woman, and I don't praise the flesh. My heart desire is to follow Jesus and to raise up a body of people that is ready for the Master's return. I do appreciate you all praying for me, and I thank God for everything. God bless you. Until when next we meet. Shalom. In Jesus' name. Amen.
In Jesus.